Hi guys, Mark here from ReviverSoft. Today I'm going to teach you how to fix a blue screen error on your computer. Now, a blue screen error is the one that you're seeing in front of you. It is a message that is displayed by Windows when it is trying to perform an action and is unable to, usually due to some kind of hardware conflict. It will display this message. This message is not the same for every individual blue screen. There's actually custom information on this screen that you should take note of. And then after the message is displayed, it will shut down your computer and the computer will then restart, and hopefully you don't get this message again, but you might continually see it happening. Now, this message that you're looking at is one that's taken from Windows XP or Vista or Windows 7. In Windows 8, the error message looks something like this. It's a lot different, it's got less text, it's a bit more friendly looking, they use a nicer font and a nicer colour and a frowny face. So it's a little bit different, but still, you know, has some important information that you need to capture, and I'll show you what information you need to capture right now. So we're going back to the Windows 7 or Windows XP error message. You can see at the top of the error message there, in this one in particular, there's a message that is all capitals and has underscores in it, and this is the part you should take note of when you are looking at the blue screen before it shuts down your computer. And if you can, a good idea is to take a photograph of this screen, because you are unable to take a screenshot because Windows has shut down, so the function that takes screenshots is also shut down. So grab your phone or grab your camera, take a photograph so you don't need to try and write this down. It's a quick way to do it. And in this case, the error message is driver IRQL not less or equal. And then in the Windows 8 error message, they actually display it in a slightly different location. You can see it down the bottom here. It's HAL initialization failed. So what you do is you take this error message and then you go to a tool that we have created, and the URL is displayed directly down below, or you can go to www.reviversoft.com/bluescreenhelper. Now I'll just type that in, if I can type. This takes you to this really useful and friendly page which shows you where to look for the error message and then gives you a box in which you can type in the error message. Now, there are tabs here for the different versions of Windows that you're using, so if you're using Windows XP, it will show you where to look for the error message and then point you to the box to click on. I'm using Windows 8, so I'll go to the Windows 8 tab, and then as soon as you start typing in here, it will find all the different error messages that match what you're typing, and you just need to select the one that you have seen on your computer. Select it, click on the button See Solution, and then you are taken to a in-depth article that we've written that tells you how to fix the specific blue screen that you are seeing on your computer. So that's a pretty simple way of doing it. The details of how to fix all the different blue screens differ depending on, you know, the blue screen that you're seeing, because the cause of the problem is different. But if you have any trouble with any of the solutions that we've provided, please leave a comment in the article. The comments are always down the bottom. And I hope that I've helped you today with your problem, and we look forward to seeing you in a future ReviverSoft video. Thanks very much.